Hey, we're back. I'm Gary Johnson, University of Minnesota, Department of Forest Resources, and this short segment is going to be devoted to mulching your new trees. Mulching is one of the best things you can do. It does three big things. One, it keeps, hopefully, lawnmowers, string trimmers away. There's no reason for lawnmowers and string trimmers to be close to the tree trunk if there's mulch around there. That's the first thing it does. Second thing it does is it holds the moisture. We talked about in another segment the dose and the frequency. If you add mulch, and this is research-based information actually from Minnesota, 2 to 4 inches of mulch, primarily organic mulch, that's what they use, that can reduce water evaporation by as much as 30%. Just think about that. So maybe you can reduce that frequency from 3 times a week to 2 times a week if you have a good mulch layer. So that's the second thing it does. Third thing it does is it moderates soil temperature. If you have bare soil and it's July and it's just beaming sunlight hitting the ground and it's hot, that soil temperature in the upper 2 to 4 inches, it can go up. Not high enough where it's going to cook the roots, but the warmer it gets, the more moisture the tree has to take up to cool off. So those three things: physical protection, moderates moisture loss, moderates temperatures. Those are the great things about it. From that point on, what do you like looking at, quite honestly? Most people like organic mulches. So this tree has an organic mulch. This is just shredded up wood from, you can get these from tree care companies or other companies too, where when they take down trees, it's just run through a chipper. And as long as you don't have problems with emerald ash borer, even if you have things like emerald ash borer, if they are finely ground, so no more than one side is no more than 1 inch long, you're not going to have a problem moving the emerald ash borer larvae into the landscape. Then organic mulches are really nice. They do look more natural, so a lot of people like that too. Again, putting down anywhere from 2 to 4, you can actually put down more than that if you want to, but 2 to 4 inches, that's kind of what you're shooting for. After you apply it, kind of go in almost like a dog digging a little hole, go around the trunk of the tree and just pull the mulch away from the trunk of the tree. What you're actually doing is you're mimicking nature. Have you ever walked through the woods, maybe it's a maple forest or an oak forest, and seen decomposing leaves and branches that are piled up architecturally against the trunk? No, you haven't seen that. Don't do that in the landscape either. So spread out the mulch, 2 to 4 inches, it's great. Pull it away from the tree, you're good to go. By the way, make sure the soil is good and moist before you put the mulch down. Mulch does not make water, it helps retain water. Now the rest of it again is personal taste. You can get colored mulches, and I know there was some controversy a few years ago about colored mulches might be toxic to plants, and experimentally that was checked out. No, there is no toxicity to it. I've even heard stories like, different colored mulches can spontaneously ignite. It's a good story, it's not true, so you don't have to worry about that either. It's just, what colors do you like? You can get them in Green Bay green, you can get them in Vikings purple, you can get them in Gophers maroon and gold. I don't know about that. But there are a lot of ways you can get them colored. You can put on polymers that keep the bark looking nice and fresh instead of kind of drying out and aging and getting gray, if that kind of stuff is an obsession. So there are a lot of different things you can do with the organic mulches. You don't have to use wood chips. You can use ground up corn cobs. Just make sure there are no corn seeds in there, because then you have a weed problem. You can use cocoa bean hulls, which really have a nice fragrance. They're beautiful. Make sure it's not windy, because if it's wind, this is a voice of experience. If it's windy, whoosh, all the hulls go away too. So there are a lot of different organic mulches to choose from. The other type of mulch we call mineral mulches or rock mulches. They're like volcanic rock mulches, come in reds and blacks, different colors than that. We're going to look at a couple of mulches that are mineral mulches that are fairly common in the landscape. So we're going to take a walk over here now. All right, we're going to look at a couple mineral mulches, and this is a trap rock. It's an aggregate stone. as opposed to washed river gravel that's a little bit more round. And we'll look at a type of washed river gravel too. There's nothing wrong with this. I know a lot of gardeners keep wanting research that shows that mineral mulches are bad. It's been done, they're not bad. Just admit it, you don't like the looks of mineral mulches. The nice thing about mineral mulches, they don't break down. They're gonna be there forever. The bad thing about mineral mulches, they don't break down. They're gonna be there forever. So I hope you like it when you put them in. They do catch leaves and stuff like that, but if you have a leaf blower, you can quickly clean it out with that. Weeds do come up through these. So sometimes with the mineral mulches, people will put down a weed barrier before they put the rock mulch down on the soil, just to kind of keep the weeds down a little bit. By the way, if you do use a weed barrier, and if your main weed problems are grasses, grasses kind of grow right up through the weaving of those weed barriers, so it may not work as wonderfully as you thought it might work. So this is one type of mineral mulch, and actually it doesn't look bad at all. There is one other interesting effect that it has, is these warm up earlier in the spring. The organic mulches, they take a long time to cool off in the autumn and the winter, and they take a long time to warm back up in the spring. Mineral mulches, sun hits them, warm up, soil warms up, the roots warm up, roots start growing when it's 40 degrees soil temperature, and you actually will have plants just starting to grow a little bit earlier, maybe get a few more days or a week or so of extra growth in that season. It's not that big of a deal. But the point of it is, it doesn't harm the soil, doesn't harm the trees. So let's look at this mulch. This is basically same type of aggregate as over there, except that is about half inch aggregate. You can see on this, it's much finer. It's down to half or a quarter inch to 3/8 inch. Little bit more of a refined look to it, if that's what you're looking for. If you're going to have a lot of traffic, I would go with the larger aggregate. It tends to not be kicked out so easily as the smaller stuff. There is one other issue with all the mulches. Mulches always end up in your turf grass. They always do. So your choice is, do you want to hit organic mulch with your lawnmower with a blade spinning at 50 miles an hour, or do you want to hit aggregate stone and have the stone go flying at 50 miles per hour. That's one of those compromises that you need to make and decide ahead of time. Are you going to be real conscientious about keeping the mulch in the bed, or do you get kind of sloppy about letting it fall out into the turf grass? Right. Last mulch we're going to look at is a washed river gravel, and it's actually a pea stone. So it is a smaller, but as opposed to this type of mineral mulch, it is it's round. It's softer. Looks a little bit more natural than the aggregate does. Let's go this way. So this is a smaller aggregate that we looked at back there. And this is pea stone. And pea stone is just, it indicates the size of a washed river gravel. So if you've ever been in the riverbeds or along the shores of some of the rivers in Minnesota, you'll see that washed river gravel. It's multicolored. The point is, it's rounded. And pea stone is 3/8 of an inch in diameter or less. So it's a nice small one. And some people really like this too. There is kind of a unique advantage to pea stone too. Critters can't burrow through it. Critters can burrow under mulch. They can actually make little houses in there. They can't do it with pea stone. So if you have a problem, you know, maybe it's a field mice or voles or something like that during the growing season, burrowing under and eating the bark or the roots of the plants, use pea stone, because as soon as they go through it, it just tumbles right back in. So, ends one problem, and I think it still looks pretty good too. So that's it, folks. That's all we're going to talk about on mulch.